Speaking of open chords, there's another song called Dog and Butterfly that makes real good use of the open chord idea. And this is, song is in A, and the chord here is this one. It's almost exactly that same open E chord, but it's, of course, the A bass is your root, and your first finger's on the second fret, fourth string, and your little finger is on the third string in your fourth fret. Everything else is open. And the pattern for it goes. So you're kind of staggering your bass notes there. And then you move to an E chord, which is, again, it's that kind of Travis-style thing there thrown in. And back to your... Travis style. So what I did right there, going from that A down to the E chord, the note that my little finger holds down here, I used a passing note, went down to a whole step down from that second fret, third string, and then your E chord. So. So there's a lot of little passing melodies that are kind of entwined in between the chord changes, like. Up on your fourth fret, it's like an A7 chord. And then your F sharp minor, B, barred B. There's a suspended note with your little finger. Take it off. And the open chord, take it off again, and then that's a D chord with an open E string, and you're hammering your fourth fret, third string there. And then put it next to it. So you move it over to your fifth string, fourth fret, and slide it up a whole step. So before we put it all together and play Dog and Butterfly, I want to introduce you to this 12 string here. 12 strings are really unique, because each string is in an octave, except for the top two, which are the same. The top two kind of sound like mandolins. It's got a very mandolinish type of sound, but there's a lot of, say, more picking type songs that can really sound great on a 12 string. And if you're accompanying just yourself, it's sort of like having twice the guitar in a lot of ways. Also, there's one other thing. If you put the just the little ones, not the regular ones, but the little ones on a six-string guitar and tune it up so that it's just the octave above your regular tuning. That's called Nashville tuning. And on the right guitar, it can sound incredible. It gives you a whole new chimey kind of sound that is just out of this world. So thought I'd mention that before I played Dog and Butterfly for you. That's the general idea. But what's cool about this song, again, is the open chord thing. This A chord, you slide it up and down. You can go up to your 7th fret. And for the ending of the song, we used to just kind of, you know, hang on the groove and just... So you got a whole cool sort of Eastern-y sounding thing when you have those open chords like that. So here